at the Empowerment Congress today, the 20th anniversary of the Empowerment Congress at USC. And we are just so grateful to be able to reach out to the over 2,000 participants today and teach and educate and raise awareness about autism and its impact on communities of color.
The issue of autism has just taken off. Well, we see it as an issue of healthcare disparity. We see it as an issue that is critically important in terms of the new frontier of civil rights for the disabled.
When they're talking about they want to stop the whole concept of Social Security, Medicaid, Medicare, these things did not come as gifts. They came out of a struggle of progressive whites and blacks and Latinos that fought for them.
When we look at health care disparities as they impact African American children, it's important for us to point out if money is made available for children with autism, for children with learning disabilities, we need to demand that money because they're not going to evenly distribute it.
We launched our campaign, Equality for Our Kids, today. Stand up, speak out, and take action.
Looking for help for my son that's 8 years old. He's actually autistic, and he's high functioning, and so I was having a lot of problems.
I truly believe in the Special Needs Network mission. I think Areva Martin is doing great things to create awareness and empower the black and brown community.
Being the parent of a special needs daughter who's 18 years old and ready for emancipation, I stand with her and her organization to say we need to support them, we need to make sure funding is available, services are available, and not just for the individuals, but for the families that support and surround those people.
How many people believe that all kids, regardless of race, regardless of your zip code, should have equal access to health care and education? If you believe that, say yes!
So we encourage everyone to support places like Special Needs Network and to make sure that all of our elected officials, from the governor on down, understand that all kids should have fair education and the dollars should be there, particularly for special needs kids.
The LA Times article that laid it out in black and white for all of us to be really crystal clear about the disproportionate lack of funding and resources African-American children with autism are receiving public dollars from a public agency was shocking.
You can't have health benefits, health treatment, health programs, spending $17,000 on one population of children and the same eligible population of children in another county only gets 2,000.
As a legislator, finally, I think that our responsibility is to shine more light and to make sure that we have more awareness and absolutely more resources coming from the government to focus on helping to improve the quality of life for special needs children and their families.
And I think it's really important for all of us in elective office and in public service generally to make the case that one child is not worth more than another child in our state.
We're here today to send a message to our governor, to send a message to our state officials, to end the discrimination against kids with autism, to give equal access to our kids because they matter.
These disparities need to be called out, they need to be dealt with, we need a plan, and we need support and leadership to make sure that the family needs and the needs of these young people are going to be addressed and corrected so that we can have healthier families in South Los Angeles and beyond.
Our country, the greatest country in the world, as the supervisor just alluded to, is that it's a participatory democracy. But that only works if folks participate. So what today represents is that engagement of giving people reasons to participate.
We need equality of treatment of students and young people with special needs. So please, 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 take a look, get yourself educated about special needs children, and check out the Special Needs Network.
So we encourage, we invite you to join us. Go to Facebook, go to Twitter, get involved in this discussion. Make your voices known. Talk to your neighbors, your religious leaders, your elected officials, and tell them that black and brown kids and that all kids with developmental disabilities matter. You can make a difference. Join our movement.